I'm happy to be here, and y'all probably noticed that Frank hadn't been here long enough to get rid of his German accent and pick up the Southern accent, but Felipe's got it down. I can tell he wants some barbecue and a drag race or something right now. In fact, and that is intuitive, because Elgin used to be named Blaney, and the biggest thing in Blaney back then was the Blaney drag strip. Has anybody been to the Blaney drag strip? One time I came over with a friend of mine, and I said, "Bill, you're taking the wrong turn." He had just a regular car. It was a Vanguard. Y'all remember those? They don't make them anymore. And I said, the stands were full of people, and we were pulling in, and I was in high school. I said, "Bill, you took the wrong turn." I said, "That's the turn over there to go to the grandstand to watch you. You going to the track." He says, "That's right. We're running tonight." I will never forget the Blaney drag strip. This is, y'all chose well. And this is a great place. It's a great state. And I will point out, when you speaking of persistence and great people, strong people who won't quit, I always like to remind people that the Revolutionary War was actually won right here in the South. When the British realized, when they came south to try to cut the colonies in two, and they ran into Francis Marion and others that we were adapting and using new tactics. That's where guerrilla warfare began. They wouldn't stand and fight. They hid behind trees and fought at night and other things that the British had never seen before. They adapted, and that is when the greatest military power on earth realized that we cannot beat the people in this country because they will not quit. We may as well go home, and that's exactly what happened. And so you're correct, Frank, to speak with the determination, the perseverance of these people. And I point out that our National Guard today is always recognized around the country as first in readiness. That means they're ready to go at a moment's notice. And that's something we can be very proud of. I am very proud of South Carolina. I don't have a whole lot to say today other than congratulations. Thank you, and thank the people of this county. This is a great county with a great history. Both some of the battles I was speaking of are fought right here. But I want to communicate clearly how the state of South Carolina is highly interested and motivated in the future. As you mentioned, this is the future. This is brain power that is reflected here. What's going on here? Y'all heard the story about communicating. The young couple didn't communicate much. They met, fell in love. He said, I love you, baby. Let's get married. She said, I love you too. Let's get married. So they got married. They didn't talk about it. Bought a little house and moved in. It wasn't long before mom-in-law moved in with them. Well, they didn't communicate with each other much or anybody else. Finally, about 2 months, the young man says, "Honey, don't you think we ought to find your mama somewhere else to stay?" He said, "My mama, I thought she's your mama." And all of them communicated. So on behalf of speaking through the governor of the state to this business and the people of this state, this is a great combination. And there are companies from all over the world that are looking to come to South Carolina. You'd be surprised, I think, to see the people that come through my office. We've got a terrific Commerce Department, Parks, Recreation, Tourism, Transportation, and we are working together more and more to be sure that all the assets, all the ideas, all the talent of the whole state are in collaborative fashion are brought to bear on whatever needs to be done, and that, of course, includes the people in the counties and in the cities, and we have good representation here with us today representing that. But we have people that come through my office from China, from India, from Japan, from Italy, from all over the world, and they're looking for the things in South Carolina. They have seen the great rapid growth that we've had. Big companies from all over the world, could be anywhere in the whole world, are coming to South Carolina. Something I discovered just recently, has anybody been to the bluffs down there in Beaufort County on the May River, the Palmetto Bluff? No, it's like a directory of who's who in commerce in the world. People from all over the place, they discover. discovered Hilton Head, and they've discovered other places. Now they've discovered Palmetto Bluff. All these people that could be anywhere in the world, and some of them have houses all over, they're coming to South Carolina. So what I say to you, this really is an extraordinary place. And since we invented air conditioning, we're really So I want to thank you for being here. Anything, and I know Ms. Funderburk will say the same on behalf of the state government. Anything that we can do to make life better for our people, the wonderful people of Kershaw County, and the wonderful, exceptional people of South Carolina, we're willing to do. And we're looking for much more, many more expansions, and we congratulate you very much on the decision. And I also have a gift for Philippe. And don't worry, I'm not going to steal whatever molecule that was you were talking about. I give a dollar to anybody who can name that molecule. Anybody who's not watching for anybody else? I didn't think so. It is a gift. It is a brass plate that we hope you'll put in a conspicuous place to remind you of the great affection and pride we have in your company and your people and the people.